India go into the Centurion Test needing a victory to keep their series hopes alive. It won't be easy though. South Africa have an imperious record at the Centurion, winning 17 out of 22 tests here. Only England and Australia have been able to win here in the last 18 years. Now the pitch is again under focus. The curator says there might not be as much lateral movement as Newlands, but there will definitely be more pace and bounce. India captain Virat Kohli might need to consider some options going into this test. With Shikhar Dhawan showing problems against the rising delivery, Kohli has the option of opening with KL Rahul, who is a much better technically equipped batsman. Among the players who didn't play in the Newlands test, Ajinkya Rahane has the highest average among all the Indian batsmen overseas. Now if he has to play, Rohit Sharma might have to make way for him. The other option for Virat is to open with Parthiv Patel. Now that way he gets to keep the left-right opening combination and as well open up Riddhiman Saha's position for Rahane to come in. But that would be an extreme option because Kohli prefers specialists.
Generally it's a good batting wicket, yeah. How they've prepared it I'm not too sure, I haven't had a look at it just yet. Generally it's good for batting, a lot of our scores there. So I'd like to think it'll be good, but I'm sure we're going to prepare it fairly similar to last week, maybe not as extreme, but it's something along those lines.
South Africa have only one spot to fill up, that of Dale Steyn, who's injured. Now they could either go with local pace sensation Lungi Ngede or Chris Morris, who is an all-rounder. Both teams had just 2 days of practice here, but South Africa will feel more comfortable at Centurion with 7 of the players coming from the Centurion ground here. They played all their life here for the Titans. India, though, on the other hand, have to not only get this election right, but also bat well to stay in the series. This is Shom Shubhro Laha from Centurion.